I'm Maeve. Let's get rolling. Actually, let me put you on here on mute really quickly. And I did all that without my glasses on. I'm so good. I'm so proud of myself. Okay, let's start seated comfortably. Just a few moments here, not too long. If you need something under your hips to kind of elevate, do so. Hands rest on thighs, eyes soften. You don't have to close them, just soften the gaze and then turn attention to breathing. And so we're gonna center our breath kind of around the heart, solar plexus, this area right here. And behind in the back. And as this breath expands forward and back, and there's nowhere else for it to go, it starts to go sideways as well. And breathes out into these upper ribs, upper side ribs. And then we gradually deepen this breath just all around so that we start to breathe forward, back, side to side, and then we start to breathe up and down at the same time, all while keeping the breath centered around this heart area. Next inhale, sweep the arms up. And then bend the elbows out to the side. Drop left hand down, reach right arm up and over. Beautiful. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bend the elbows. And then right hand down, left arm up and over. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, elbows bend, then pause here. Lift the heart up. Back ribs support you. One more breath in, and then release the hands down. Come around, hands and knees. Rock your weight a little side to side, right and left. And then a little back and front. And then we're gonna circle. And reverse. We're gonna come through center. Tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Take your feet nice and wide, like as wide as your mat, or maybe almost as wide as your mat, or if you're fairly tall, maybe even off of your mat, but a wide leg down dog. Really root the hands into the ground. Start to feel the toes connecting down. The base of the big toe, base of the pinky toe. Start to drag the feet back and wide. And then keep your feet this wide. Keep the legs really strong and just start to walk your hands back to your feet. Your legs can be straight or bent, whatever feels better on your body. And then bend the right knee, left hand plants, reach the right hand up. So bend the right knee, reach the right hand up. Yeah. Beautiful. Release that down. Come back to center. We switch sides. Left knee bends, right hand stays down, left hand comes up. Release that hand down. Walk out to a strong plank. Keep the feet wide. Keep the feet nice and wide here. Pick up the right leg. Get lighter in the left hand. Maybe reach that left hand forward. Hand and foot down. Stay down dog. Just press back. And then glide forward to plank again. And then pick up your left leg. Get light in the right hand. Maybe reach it forward. Release the hand, release the foot, and downward facing dog. And then just rock your weight a little side to side, right and left. Press really deeply into one heel and then the other. Let the hips sway a little bit. Maybe start to bring the feet closer together, but maybe not. And then just find your center. A few breaths here in down dog. Right knee into your chest. Exhale. Place the right foot forward. Left knee down. Straight in the right leg. Half split. Yes. Beautiful. Beautiful. Rebend the front leg. Rise up on Anjaneyasana. Left arm reaches up and over, right hand just drops to the right side. If you have a block, you could put your hand on a block. Maybe you come to the floor, but we're pretty early on. Don't force anything. Inhale, reach back up. Left hand down, right hand reaches to the sky. Tuck the back toes, lift the back knee. Draw your feet toward each other energetically. Pull front foot back, back foot front. Beautiful. Very, very nice. Check back in with your breath. If you're comfortable in Ujjayi, start to feel that sort of sense of fogging outward and then drawing back. Right hand releases down. Step back to plank. Breath in and plank. To the belly, exhale. Use your knees if needed. Float the feet up. Take the arms out to the side today, Shalabhasana. Straight out to the side. Lift the legs a little longer, a little higher. Take another breath in. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Take a breath in. And exhale, left knee into your chest. Place the foot forward, right knee down. And then straighten the front leg. Half split. Beautiful. Very nice. Good, good, good. Nice. With your exhale, rebend the front leg. Your inhale, Anjaneyasana, rise up. Good. Drop the left arm off to the side, right arm up and over. Good. Points in the floor, foot or feet, I should say. Feet and knee pressing down and everything drawing in towards center. Inhale, drawing back up. And then right hand comes down. Right knee lifts up. Keep drawing the feet toward each other and twisting open to the left. Let the twist be gentle. Let the breath be expansive. Release your left hand down, step back to plank, breath in, belly exhale. Arms out, and Shalavasana. And then downward facing dog. And take a pause here. Recenter your breath. With an inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees. Bring your feet up to your hands. And then come halfway with your inhale. Hold with your exhale. Push the ground away. Inhale, rise up to stand. And then draw your hands into your heart with your exhale. Beautiful. I'm Maeve. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway inhale. Fold back down with your exhale. Rise up to stand. Inhale. And then draw your hands into your heart. Exhale. Beautiful. Inhale, rise up. Exhale and bow. Halfway. Inhale. Fold. Exhale. Rise. Inhale. And draw your hands back to your heart again. Exhale. Beautiful. One more half salute. Inhale. Rise up. Exhale. Bow forward. Halfway. Inhale. Fold. Exhale. Rise. Inhale. Push the ground away. And draw your hands into your heart. Inhale. Rising up. Beautiful. Exhale, bowing forward. Lengthening halfway, inhale. Right foot steps back. Right knee to the ground. Straighten the front leg and shift back. Ardha Hanumanasana, beautiful. Inhale, come forward. Rise up, Anjaneyasana. Left hand to the left side, right arm up and over. Big side. Inhale, rise back up to the center. Gorgeous, bring your hands down. Lift the right knee. Use that right hand. Twist open to the left. Inhale. Exhale. Release the hand to the ground. Plank. Inhale. Belly down. Exhale. Beautiful. Cobra. Inhale. Yes. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Very nice. Take a couple breaths here. Settle. And then with an inhale, right leg stretches back. The hips square for this first one. Draw your knee down your chest, or to your chest. Put the right foot forward. Left knee down gently. And then straighten the front leg, shift back. Beautiful. Come forward. Rise up, Anjaneyasana. Left hand continues to reach up, right hand drops to the side. Beautiful. Inhale, come back up. And then left hand to the ground. Left knee lifts and twists. Beautiful. Release your right hand down and then step your left foot, your back foot, to the top of your mat. Come halfway with your inhale. And fold with your exhale. Rise, inhale. Lift the heart to your thumbs. Bow right back down, exhale. Inhaling halfway. Left foot steps back. Left knee gently to the ground. Straighten the front leg and shift back half foot. Beautiful. Come forward, rise up, Anjaneyasana. Right hand down, left hand up. Inhale, rise up. Left hand down, left knee lifts. We twist to the right. Beautiful. Release the right hand down. Plank, inhale. And then belly, exhale. Strong legs, push the tops of the feet down. Curl, cobra, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Left leg back with your inhale. And then place your left foot forward. Right knee gently down and straighten the front leg, shift back. Very nice. Come forward, rise up, Anjaneyasana. Side bend to the left, left hand down, right arm up and over. Inhale, come back up. And then release the right hand down. Straighten the back leg and twist. Left hand to the ground. Step to the top of your mat. Come halfway with your inhale. And then fold with your exhale. Rise up to stand. Inhale. Draw your hands into your heart. Exhale. So good. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bowing forward. Halfway inhale. Right foot steps back. This time crescent. Inhale, rise up. Bring your hands into your heart. Right arm outside left thigh, we twist a little deeper, but still giving yourself tons of space here. A few breaths here. One more breath in. Release your hands down. Take this left leg up and back, open up the left hip, bend the knee. And then maybe consider coming into wild thing on the right hand, right foot, left foot behind. Take a breath in, come around to plank, exhale all the way down to the ground again. This time slide your forearms forward, come into Sphinx. Take a couple breaths here, gorgeous, yes. And then tuck your toes and forearm plank. Good. Press the space between the shoulder blades toward the sky. It's beautiful. Take another breath in and then hips release down. Inhale, Sphinx. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Inhale, right leg stretches back. Right foot comes forward between your hands. Crescent pose, rising up. And then draw your hands into your heart. And left arm outside your right thigh, twist to the right. Beautiful. Good. One more breath in, so good. Release your hands down. Just straighten out that right leg, little pause. I'm not sure if I did this on the first side or not, but it feels good. Good. And then soften the knee. Sweep this right leg up and back. Open up the hip if it feels good. Bend the knee if it feels good. And then if you want to follow that foot around, coming around into wild thing. Beautiful. Yes. And then coming around. All the way down to your belly with control. And then curling up. Cobra. And downward facing dog. Little pause. Rise high to your toes and hands. Bend your knees, look forward, bring your feet to your hands. Come halfway, inhaling. Fold with your exhale. Chair, inhale. Press up, little lift of the heart, and then forward fold. Come halfway with your inhale. Left foot steps back. Crescent, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Twist it over to the right. Left arm outside, right thigh. Beautiful. Good. Release your hands down. Straighten the front leg. And then rebend. Good. Sweep right leg up to the sky. Open the hip. Wild thing if you care to. Yes. Beautiful. Come back around. Lower to your belly with care. Sphinx, inhale. And then exhale, forearm plank. You're here a couple breaths. Beautiful. Use your toes. Thighs to the sky, gorgeous. Come back to Sphinx, inhale. And then downward facing dog, exhale. From dog, left leg back, inhale. Exhale, place your foot between your hands. Rise, crescent. Hands into your heart. And then twist it over to the left. Release the hands down. Straighten that front leg. Good, rebend. And then sweep the left leg back. Open up the hip. Consider flipping over. And then back around for plank. Lower to your belly with care. Cobra, inhale. and downward facing dog with your exhale. Spectacular. Take a few breaths here. Just reset the breath. Really beautiful. Really beautiful. Inhale, lift your heels. Stretch back, look where you're going, feet to your hands, look where you're going. Come halfway, inhale. And fold, exhale, gorgeous. Chair, inhale. Press up to stand, little standing back bend here. Drive the legs, lift the heart, and then draw your hands into your heart. Inhale, circle to rise up. Exhale and bow. Halfway, inhale. Plank, lower down either to chaturanga or the floor. And then your choice of back bends. We've done cobra, we've done sphinx, shalabhasana. Now you've got an up dog at your disposal and downward facing dog. Beautiful. Soft, even breath. Keep it constant. Rise to your toes. Bend your knees. Look forward, feet to hands. Halfway, inhale. Gorgeous. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Push the ground away. Lift the heart. Lift the back ribs. Draw your hands into your heart. Exhale. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Your path to downward facing dog. Inhale to toes. Exhale, stretch back, look forward, feet to hands. Halfway, inhale, and then fold down, exhale. Rise to stand, inhale, push the ground away. And draw your hands into your heart. Inhale, rising up. Exhale and bow. Halfway, inhale. Take it back. Chaturanga or straight to dog, your choice how you get there. Beautiful, beautiful, yes. And you're gonna take a few breaths in downward facing dog, please. Inhale, right leg back. Bring your right knee to your right shoulder, your tricep, as high up on your elbow as you can. Take a breath, lift it higher. Exhale, bring the knee down to your wrist. And then inhale, lift up to the armpit. Yep. Exhale, drop down to the wrist. Inhale, lift up, take the leg up and back, open up the hip. Flip to wild thing if it's there and it feels good. We've done a few of them already. If you've had enough, you've had enough. Beautiful. And then right foot, top of the mat. Fantastic. Half moon. Pick up that back leg, roll open. Option to bend the top leg. Don't take the foot yet though. Just pull that foot toward your sitting bone. And scoop the belly back. And just work that hamstring. Yes, gorgeous. So, so good. Yeah. Now, if it feels good, reach back for that foot with your top hand, either hand actually, but reach back with your hand and then kick the foot into the hand. So you're actually going the opposite way than you were going before. Pull the heel toward your sitting bone. release the foot with the hand, and then stretch the left leg back out. Bend the right knee, lean forward like crazy, and then reverse warrior. Take it back, that nice big side bend we've seen a few times. Gorgeous, yes, so good, so good. Yeah, beautiful. Mm-hmm. Good. Take one more breath in. Bring your hands down to the ground. Step back to plank with an inhale. Chaturanga or the floor, or skip it and go right to down dog. Just make your way through. Check back in with your breath. Smooth it out. Mm-hmm. Very nice. Very nice. Left leg back with an inhale. And then left knee to left shoulder. Stay forward. Inhale, lift the knee up higher. And then exhale, drop to the wrist. And then lift up with the inhale. And then drop to the wrist. So good. One more time. Inhale up to the shoulders. Stretch back. Open the hip. Flip over if it feels good. And then left foot, top of the mat. Half moon, taking off. The first is find your foundation. Get settled there. Yes. Beautiful. So, so nice. And then slowly start to bend the top leg if you want. Yes, good, Mary, beautiful. And just pull the heel toward your sitting bones. So good, Jordan. Yep. Then if you want to take the foot with a hand, you take the foot and then push that foot away. Yes, beautiful. And then draw the heel back in toward the sitting bone. Bend the front leg, release the leg with the foot, the hand. Yep, reverse warrior back. So beautiful. Mm-hmm. So nice. Mm-hmm. Take another breath in. Bring the hands around. Step back to plank, inhale. And then your path to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your heels, bend your knees, exhale, feet to your hands. Come halfway with your inhale, hold with your exhale. Chair, inhale, hands into your heart, left arm outside, right thigh. Let's twist our chair, gorgeous, yes. Draw length into both sides of the body. Take another inhale, forward fold, pause there. Come back into chair, inhale, hands into your heart, second side, right arm outside left thigh, gorgeous, yes. Twisting that chair. Really nice. Really nice. Really spacious on both sides of the body. Mm-hmm. Gorgeous. Yes, yes. You look amazing. Couple more breaths here. Good. Come back to chair in the center. And then forward fold with your exhale. Little pause here. Draw your heart forward with your inhale. And then make your way to down dog. Good. Really good. Take a few breaths in downward facing dog. Reconnect breath. So nice. Maybe lift all your toes up. Good. And start to drag the heels back more. Good. And then just pause. Just pause. With your breath, right leg back, inhale. Right knee, right shoulder. Inhale, lift up higher. Exhale, release the knee down to the wrist. Inhale, three-legged dog, open up wild thing. If you wanna take this a little deeper, if your body feels like ready to flip it all the way, the right hand comes around, left hand pivots. You come into Urdhva Dhanurasana. I think coming out is a little trickier than coming in. You have to kind of soften the elbows, flip that left hand back around, and then right foot top of the mat. Half moon, take off. Tapasana, if you'd like, bending that top leg, push the foot away. And then bend the standing leg. Release the foot if you have it, reverse warrior. Yes, yes, yes. So good. And then bring the hands around. Step back to plank, breath in. And lower down. Heart to sky, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Little pause, just receive all that. Left leg sweeps back, inhale. Left knee, left shoulder, exhale. Inhale, lift higher. Exhale, lower to the wrist. Inhale, sweep up and back. Open the hip, wild thing if you'd like, and if you want, flipping this all the way around, you've got to kind of pick up the right foot. Put the left hand down, flip the right hand. Your fingers point toward your heels. Let your feet be wide, let it feel great. So good. So come out, kind of soften. Flip the right hand. Left foot top of the mat. Half moon, bring it around. So good. Bend the top leg if you want, find the foot. Shavasana. And then reverse warrior back. Breath in, yes. And then hands to the ground. Vinyasa or just down dog. Nice, soft, smooth, steady breath. Fantastic. Fantastic. Yourself this moment. Inhale, lift your heel. Stretch back, look forward, feet to hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair, inhale. Right knee rises up, lift up. Left hand to your right knee, maybe to your foot, and then open up. Yes, so good. Stand on that left leg, yes, beautiful. You can take your foot without straightening your leg, you're beautiful, perfect. Perfect, just know that. Hey, Susan. So good. Inhale, come back around. Keep that right leg lifted. Slowly take that right leg back. So options, warrior three. Okay, that's actually not open for negotiation. I mean, variations in it, of course, but we're gonna just stay here for a moment. And then hands a good like foot and a half in front of that left foot for a standing split. So it's a long, or like a really spacious stance. Good. Stay here or rock forward and start to take some lifts for handstand. Beautiful. And then chair. And then left knee rises up. And reach for the knee with the right hand or to the foot. Yeah, gorgeous. And again, you can take the foot without straightening the leg. Work on straightening the standing leg, lifting the heart. So good. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Come around slowly. Warrior three. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. And then hands come down to the ground. And take them a good chunk in front of you. And first to start with standing splits. Stay there or start to rock forward and consider taking some lifts. Yes, really good. Beautiful. And then chair with your inhale. Fantastic. Rise up, bring your hands into your heart, step your left foot back, root the back heel. Give yourself a wide enough stance without like looking at it, just getting a sense of feel that you feel very secure, very like not tightropey, not gonna fall over from side to side. And then just hinge from that right hip and bow forward. Yeah. Keep pulling the heart forward. And we're going to let this be nice and easy today. Left hand inside of the right foot. Right hand to the sky. Tons and tons of space in this revolved triangle. Mm-hmm. Gorgeous. Beautiful. Off in front knee, pick up the back heel, come up, revolved half moon. Option to bend the left leg, reach back with your right hand, take the foot, and then kick it away. And then back into chair. And press up to stand and bring your hands into your heart. And then right foot steps back. Just find your stance. Root the back heel down. Take a breath in. Lift the heart. From the crease of the left hip, come forward. Draw forward, draw forward, draw forward. Beautiful. Just like that. Really nice. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Yes, we're gonna allow this twist to be incredibly spacious. Right hand comes down to the ground. Lengthen the spine forward. Draw the feet toward each other, left hand to the sky. Revolve triangle. Last inhale. And then bend the front leg, lift the back heel. Right hand stretches forward, revolved half moon. Option to take the back foot, Chapasana. Good. Yes, let me see you. Yes, 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 yes. And then chair. And forward fold. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Step to plank, please. And then lower to your belly. Bend both of your knees. Good, you can keep your hands on the floor if you want. If you want, you'll reach back for your feet. Dhanurasana, pushing the feet into the hands, gorgeous. Yep, your knees can go wide. It's so fine for them to go wide. You're not gonna crunch your back unless it feels like it doesn't feel good. Otherwise, you're golden. Let it be as easy as it needs to be on this first one. One more inhale. Release out. Forearms come down, forearm plank. To walk your feet toward your elbows. Come into dolphin. You can lace your hands if it feels better on your body. Check in with your breath. Good. Come back out to forearm plank. And then Sphinx, release the hips down, so good. Tops of the feet press down, pull the heart through. Good. Stay with these arms at least initially, start to bend the knees. Good. And then if you want, elbows come out to the sides, sweep back. Dhanurasana number two. So now that you've seen this twice, maybe the knees start to move toward each other, but maybe they don't. Good. Last inhale. And then release with your exhale. Forearms, forearm plank to dolphin. And again, lace the hands if it feels better on your body. With an inhale, right leg lifts up. Maybe start to take some little hops here. Just kind of tipping. Beautiful. Forearm plank. And then Sphinx. And then bend the knees. Last chance at Dhanurasana. Opening up. Really good. Release it. Forearms down, forearm plank. Feet toward elbows, dolphin again. And then left leg lifts up. You do not have to go anywhere. If you want, you can start to just kind of take these little tips. Really nice. And then knees down and child's pose. Unless, of course, you're in Pinchamayarasana and you feel good there, you can stay there. Otherwise, come on down. Bring your right foot forward. Left knee stays down. Nice, easy, easy, easy twist here. Right hand on your right thigh. Beautiful. Maybe take the back foot with your right hand. Okay. And then if you want to take this deeper, which you don't ever have to do, you can take this left arm outside the right. And maybe bring the hand down. Squeeze that left glute. Beautiful. Release out. Straighten the front leg, shift back, half splits. Maybe you want to take this deeper. If you do, you can extend the front leg forward. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. If you're in a full split, carefully draw the right leg back. Everyone bend the right knee, walk the right foot across. We're coming into pigeon here. Good. You're going to turn your heart toward your right foot. So you're going to turn to the left a bit and then walk out from there. Keep pressing down into the back foot. So good. Come back around through center. And then just step back, plank. Good. Knees down, stretch back. Have a beaten child's pose. And then rise up, left foot comes forward. Left hand onto your left knee or thigh. Easy, easy twist. Stay here or bend the back leg, reach back. With your left hand for your right foot. Still perfect. If you'd like, right arm can come outside of left thigh, and then if you'd like from there, right hand can come down. And just don't expect it to feel exactly the same on this side. It feels totally different on my body on this side. Engage that right glute. Beautiful. Really nice. Release that. Straighten the front leg. Half splits or full splits if you care to. Or anything in between. Anything in between. Yeah. Beautiful. So pretty. And then carefully drawing back and bending the front leg, walking the foot across, coming into single leg pigeon, turning the torso, the heart toward that left foot. So you're kind of off to the right side of it. Yes. So good. Very nice. Coming back through center. Tuck the back toes. So transitioning out, just as important as being in the pose, come back into plank. And then knees down and stretch it back. Just a beat in child's pose. And then rising up, come around to seated. I'm gonna take the legs out wide. Beautiful. Good. You're gonna draw your right foot into your inner left thigh and then reach over. Good. Wrap the chest open to the sky. And then maybe this top arm comes up and over. This side of my body, my left side of my body, I think it's from having a three-year-old. I've been carrying on this side for 3 years. I could be here all day. Like this, I could stay here all day. I also think it won't release, but it just feels good. It feels so good. I won't torture you though. We won't stay all day. Rise up with an inhale. One piece at a time, leg comes out. Reset and center. And then opposite side. And then we go. Okay, this side feels good too. I guess I just need this. I guess I just need it all the time. Rise back up. Good. This time, bring the other foot into me, Baddha Konasana. Try to pull the feet in as close to your hips as you can. You can hold the feet. Press the feet into each other, and from that action of pushing the feet together, feel the knees start to open. You never want to force the knees open. Press the pinky sides of the feet down and feel how that draws you open. Good, 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 good. And then maybe you shift forward. Maybe you don't. Maybe you keep your hands behind and give yourself that extension, which is totally fine. Not just totally fine, it's fantastic. And then rise up, inhaling. Good. And I'm just gonna cross the shins. We're gonna twist. And then twist the other way. Good. Come back to center. Roll onto your backs. I have to go sideways because my tailbone's all busted up. All right. And then knees toward your chest, Apanasana. Give yourself a squeeze here. Take a few breaths, belly, ribs, heart. Start to feel the knees splitting out to the side as you pull the knees in a little closer toward your shoulders. And keep the big toes together. And then reach down for your feet. So you're basically in Baddha Konasana here, in the feet. Let the knees go as wide as they want. So really draw the feet toward your hips. And then separate the feet, take your heels from the inside and come into happy baby. Good. Depending on how your body feels, stay here. If it feels good, straighten out the legs completely. And then rebending the legs. Draw the feet in. Release the feet down. Supta Baddha Konasana. Take a breath here. And then release the legs completely out. Neutralize your spine. Let the feet fall open. Palms to the sky. Backs of the hands in the ground. Eyes soften. Breath releases and becomes natural and easy. Allow your breath to deepen. And through the breath, start to return to your body, hands and feet, arms and legs. Stretch your arms overhead. Bend your knees and then roll to your right side. And then from there, pressing down into the ground with your hands, rise up to sitting. And just sit comfortably, coming back to where we started. Your hands rest on your thighs. Come back to that sense of the breath being centered at the heart and behind the heart. Allow it to be gentle. And just feel the effects of your practice today. It's different every day. Next inhale, bring your hands to your heart. With your exhale, bow your mind to your heart. Rise, inhaling, eyes open gently. Thank you, thank you. Beautiful practice. Okay. Thanks, you guys at home.